Okay, it's fine. We fixed it. It wasn't a long time. It's like, shut up. Shut up in the stream. Too much face palming going on. Okay, right, I want to wait for a train coming down. Come on. Oh, wait, it comes from this way, doesn't it? Oh man, I forgot how epic this was. Yes. Okay, yeah. So, yeah, you guys, basically, you need to see where this rail line comes in. Because you think, like, oh yeah, look, the rail line's, like, following the road, and then it heads over here. So it must go off up in this distance, right, over here? No, that's not what it does. It goes here, look, and then it loops back under the road, and then the rail line, look, it goes all along here, on the edge of the mountainside, look. It goes all along here, and then it goes off in the distance over here. That's where it goes to. It's like the best rail journey you've ever seen in your life. Trouble is, we have to actually have trains using it first, so. This rail should be working now. I see no reason why it should not work. But again, this is all part of testing this map, making sure that it works for people. It may well be that it's just like, takes a bit of time. I'm not sure. We'll see what happens. Oh, an event has finished. Oh, yeah, the events cause a lot more traffic, you know, so. Anyway, I think it's looking good. It's all working. Right, we've got some more. Ah, finally, look, Ramus's party town has got his first little shops in here. Oh, actually, it just occurs to me, those are standard commercial because I have not designated that as actually a nighttime party town. So, leisure specialization. Vibrant nightlife, etc. So I needed to actually put that on there. Sorry about that. Right, okay, let's get a little bit more in here. Fill this in. Get some party happening. There we are, it's all going to be kicking off there now. Do I have to pay extra for taking the train with a view? I would imagine so. Especially if it's one of those trains where it's got the glass carriages, you know, the viewing towers and so on. I still haven't seen any trains come through. It's kind of weird. It's all definitely connected up. But I don't know. Maybe there's no passengers required or something. Seems like it should be working. Ah, stealing my rings. Thank you very much. Get the rings going on. Yes, a smoke bomb, yes. Thank you very much, Yaris. Appreciate it, buddy. Show Yaris some ice cream sandwich in the chat if you got it. If you've got it. We'll keep an eye on this train situation. I am 100% certain that I definitely connected it up. Like, outside the area. See, it goes all the way over here, look. Edge of the map. Ooh, or did I? That could be a problem. Do you know what? We're gonna have to do a critical check. Because this could be an issue. It could be that I did not connect the rail line when I made the map. We are gonna check. I don't normally do this on a stream, but I'm going to check because this is by a map that is actually connected up. Because I have a worrying feeling that maybe for whatever reason I forgot to. And this is why we're testing this map, because, you know, before I put it on the Steam Workshop, I want to make sure it's actually all working. It crashes every time I go back to main menu. It crashes now. Which is why I always have to make sure to save. Right, let's go check the map and make sure. I'll give you a little tour around while we're at it. Right, here we go. Yeah, there is another rail line somewhere. I think it's down to the south, and that one is definitely connected up because I remember. I expect what maybe happened was that when I put it in, I maybe was so. Because I remember it was very difficult to get it to come down the way I wanted to, and I expect that I. Somebody going a bit crazy on a motorbike. It's a bit fast. Where is it? This is it. Yeah, it was very, very difficult for me to get that rail line to come in the way that it does. And so I think that I got so caught up on making it come in, I potentially forgot to actually connect it up to the edge of the map, which is what it looked like to me. But that's really important. It's important that I notice that now before I put this live on the Steam Workshop. So we will see. Wait for these things to load. They always take forever now. But yeah, I very easily can bring a rail line up to there to connect, and especially now that we have the areas unlocked, I can just unlock the areas down and I'll run a rail line up there to get that working. But I just wanted to know for my own sort of knowledge. Thanks for coming and joining on the stream today, guys. If you don't normally follow me on the stream, then please go check out my other YouTube channel, which is Looting Gaming. So you can find at looting gaming. That's my other channel, guys, where you can find all of the Skyline stuff. So the rest of this playthrough, up until the point that I put it on YouTube anyway, is there. I meant to post an episode yesterday, but did not, so I will post it tomorrow, because it's Thursday. Well, actually, it's Thursday now, so... there we go. Come on, map, load. Load for all your life. Ba-ba-ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba. Come on, load up for me. It's loading gone. Come on. Bringing it. Here we go. Right, so let's go check. So this is the whole map. Bastard. I knew it. God damn it. Yeah, there is another rail line somewhere down here. Here it is. See, this one definitely goes to the edge. Can't believe I forgot to do that. It's probably because I was so busy, like, fiddling around with the other ones. This one goes all the way across here, and it comes in here. So I could go a couple of grid squares down and bring it in that way, but then I have to go all through there. Probably the easiest thing to do is going to be to go, like, oh, but I won't be able to connect to that point because it's outside the area. Because this is the limitations of the grids right here, so I have to go to this west connection. But anyway, you can see more, like, from here, how cool the outside route for this rail line is. Because, like I say, look, it goes all the way along here, like the edge of this map, and then it comes round, and then it goes down through this little valley. It's a shame that you don't get to see all this. It comes around here, da-da-da-da, big spanning bridge, and then across to here. So anyway, let's put that in and save it. So that for the future, it will actually work. Right, there we go. Because I say, I'm going to put this on the Steam Workshop, probably, well, I say every time I played soon, but it's because we're continuing to test. Now, the other thing people have asked about before is the boats, okay, with shipping. And if I look for that, so you can see with the shipping, I have not tested it, but theoretically it does come in and turns around on this point here, but I do not know whether it will actually work. So theoretically, yes, there is a connection in the area, but it's only in this, like, port harbor area. My thought was that you could build, like, a you know, like a cargo port here and then connect it up there. But I don't know. I don't know whether that would actually work or not. So, yeah. I don't know about that. Other resources as well. So resources. There's some minerals down here. There's a big mineral patch here. Plenty of trees. There's a small mineral patch right there. Some big oil deposits up on the top. Some more mineral wealth. Trees, trees, trees. There's a bit more oil down in there. There's a bit more there, which is where we're mining that out from. Yeah, and that's it. So I'm going to put this on Steam pretty soon, guys, so you guys can have a chance to play this map. It's a pretty good map. As I say, we've been having a lot of fun with this one. It's quite a challenging map because you've really got to, you know, use your sort of road system. The start area as well, as I say, I positioned the start area in quite a tricky place because your land space to build on is quite limited, you know. Anyway, I'm going to save this one and get back to the main game. Okay, well, let's see if we can go back to the main menu without crashing. Nope, not that. Quit to main menu. Don't crash this time. Don't crash. It's gonna crash, yeah. Actually, I haven't looked at how good my... Yeah, it crashed, of course. It seems to be unable to do this. Right, whilst we're back here, you can't actually see, but I'm just going to go to the Steam Workshop. I'm just going to see how my new map has been doing, because I did post one up there recently. Files you've posted. Let's see whether I've got any. Well, my Castle Valley one, it has been downloaded a lot, but I'm still to get any stars on it, which is a shame. But current subscribers is 719. So far I've got a couple of comments in there. Looks nice, awesome with the medieval star pack, nicely made like the islands, it's all smoothly, carefully done, excellent, thumbs up and a favourite. Blah blah blah, so yeah, it's looking good. Somebody can link that. Somebody wants to go on my Steam Workshop, guys, and link the map. Actually, I can probably do it myself, actually. Let's start the game though whilst I'm doing that. Here it is. There you go, guys. That's one of the most recent maps that I put up. I did a little bit of video about it on there as well. Oh, actually, did I? I don't think I put the video actually on the. I didn't put the video on the Steam page, which I should probably do. But it's had 700 downloads so far, so quite popular. Right, let's load the game back in. So if you download the map, guys, and you check it out and you like it, please be sure to actually rate it on Steam. It really helps me out, because then that way, if I think people often, they subscribe but they forget to actually rate. It's not very obvious on Steam because it's like a little grey button and you don't really see it. But if you rate it, then the Steam Workshop item gets the stars, and then stars help more people to see it, so it's a good way to like share, and if people enjoy it, to show other people for it. So yeah. Right, now we just have to get back in. But anyway, that's good to know that freaking railway thing doesn't work. Ugh. Now I'm gonna have to find a workaround. It's gonna be annoying. Lean, I just liked it, but I can't find how to rate it. Well, I think it's like, that's what I'm saying. When you click up, I'll show you. Yeah, it says rate. It probably is like, dude. That's probably what you're thinking about. It is like. So I'm just playing with a pen on my desk. Anyway, but yeah, I have been playing that map myself because I tested it out the day I put it on Steam, and it actually played really good. I was surprised actually how well it played, because I thought it was quite a simplistic map, but it actually worked out really good in the end. God, I feel tired today. It's like several nights of like 5 a.m. Overwatch, and it sort of catches up with you. Cheers, love. All that bollocks. Alright, back in the mix. So much tired. Right, okay, we're back on the map, and so we have discovered that, to my horror, in creating this map, I did not actually connect this external line. So there's no reason for us to actually have a line up here, so I'm just going to delete this out to save the space, but, which is annoying. the actual version that I will put on Steam Workshop, this will be working, because we've just taken the time to go correct it and fix that. But basically, there is no reason for us to have a rail line this way, but we will find a different solution to get this rail connection working. So, and it's probably going to be even more sort of experimental than what I've got going on here. Right, so... So we should be able to, like, basically head out this way. And I think... Right, let's see if we've got it off of that. Obviously, I know that I can purchase more areas as well, but we're just going to check. Now, where does that line come in? It's like up here, right? Or here. Where is it? It's right here. There we are. So we have got a rail line here. Now we just got to figure out how the hell we're going to connect it and where it's going to come in on. I think it'll probably come in on, like, here. We could bring it across and then have it follow the road into town. But then we've got to bring the rail line somehow all the way over to here, which is slightly tricky. The other option could be cooler. I'm just thinking of, like, yeah, actually I've got a good idea. Okay, I've got it. I've got it. I've got the idea. I know what we're going to do. I'm going to build it in reverse so that I make sure that I get the route correct. This is going to be cool, though. This is going to be a good one. This is going to be proper LT building all the way. Right, here we are. Can you build it underground? Yeah, you can do, but I've got a good idea. The only thing is, though, is that we may have to... Do I want to go over these houses? I think the answer is yes. I'll probably have to destroy some houses in the process. Now, do you know what? Let's try. Bollocks. Let's try it. This is going to be an unpopular decision. So I'm going to build a overground railway here. Yeah, so this is going to be an interesting one. Yeah, see, that's my thing. It's like, are we going to be able to do... Yeah, here we go. Some houses may have to be destroyed in the process. This is going to be awesome. I might actually just switch to the straight line tool here for the moment. Ooh, getting proper bridge tunnel-y stuff going on. Now we have to try and do this whilst destroying the minimum amount of houses possible. I also need to get it... Actually, let's just see what happens if I just stretch it out. Like, how many buildings we destroy. Because I basically want to go, like, over here. I mean... Oh, hello. Okay, so let's see. So if we come straight line almost, like, to there... How many people's lives do we destroy? Only about 3. That's okay. I can handle 3 people's lives destroyed. I think that's okay. So let's just go with that. Awesome. Oh yes, this is happening. Yeah, this looks nice. Oh shit. Bad luck, sorry about your house. We'll pay you good dividends or whatever. Sorry about that. We're making it work. Right, okay, so now here's my elegant plan. right, let's just keep it going. Right, so you'll see where this is going. Okay, so I'm going to keep it raised, by the way, for now. You'll see why. I just want to make sure that the, yeah. Right, so I'm going to tweak this as I go. Hold on, bear with me a sec. I'm just trying to find the right line in on this, basically. Come down a little bit. Should I get this in? Yeah, here we go. So I'm just trying to get the line I want on this. There we go. So just like that. And then, what we're going to do is we're going to go a little bit crazy. There we go. A little bit crazy here. Mayor Luton providing opportunities to families needed to start a new life. Vote Luton. Yeah. Right, here we go. Here we go. Yes, my friends. This is what's going to happen. We're going to tunnel through the frickin' mountain. Oh yes. There we go. Oh, that's a little bit more of an extreme entrance than I want. We can tweak this bit in a while. Right, so through it goes. Oh, that is one weird exit. Look at that. What the hell is up with that? That is so odd. That is not how I imagined the exit of the tunnel to look. It's a little bit too insane for me. So we're going to have to bring it down. Wow, that is some crazy shit. Okay, let's actually just go in a minute. I'm actually going to slightly delete this back a little bit, if I can. Basically, what I want to do is I want to bring it back a bit. It's not very easy to delete this without accidentally deleting other stuff at the same time. I'm trying to be careful. It's also quite tricky to find the node to connect it back on. There we go. Whoa, what the hell? Oh, that is high up. Is that really where that's from? No, that can't be right. Totally can't be right. Oh wow, look, yeah, it's like just, it's like a roller coaster. Roller coaster. Right, anyway, so I want to bring it down like this. I make sure I keep a bit of a straight line as well. Oh, you son of a bitch. Right, here we go. And it's still too high. It's quite tricky to figure out exactly where you need to bring it down to. I guess it's sort of like, when you look at it like this, it's a little bit easier to get your head around it. So let's go back. What we need to do is bring it down a little bit before it gets to that point, so when it comes out on the level, basically. Yep, thanks. See that, Walnuts. So we need to bring it just down like this. Yeah, this is Luton's great train project, basically. Right, so again, if we come up now. There we go. Much better, alright? Much better. Well, let's have a look here. Yeah, so this will be fine. So I'm just going to bring this out like here. There we are. Look, that's not too bad. We can get away with that. And I say we can tweak the other bit shortly. Neil says, Luton is building the greatest railway ever. It'll be really great. It's going to be huge. It's going to be tremendous. You're going to love it. I've spoken to loads of people, right? I've spoken to loads of people who build railways. They love me. They love what I'm trying to do with railways. It's going to be amazing. You're going to love it. All right. It's so good. I've got a lot of friends who like to build railways, you know. They know me. They know that I'm good at building railways. Right, okay. Let's get this going on to... I want this... meh. Okay, that'll do. Right, so we're going to have to go up and over, and then into the tunnels yet again. Too steep, it says. Pain in the ass. How can it be too steep? It's ridiculous. Okay, we're going to have to go to the freeform railway yet again, I guess. Okay, here we go. So now we have to go through another tunnel. Let's get another straight line going on. It's quite a wide entrance. Yeah, there we go. Right, so now we need to get this all the way over here. Intriguing. There we are, that coming, bring it out here. So I'm gonna bring it to like here, and then just come up a bit. And we're a little bit high, but we'll work this out. That's fine. I think we can. Yeah, there we are. Look, get away with that. That's all right. Looking good. Okay, so that's going through to there. This is definitely going to be like looting the great LT railway. Going okay, through here, this is going to be epic. It's going to look so awesome when the trains are coming in and out on this. It's going to be amazing. The only bit that is not good is that bit right there. That's the bit that needs like a little tweak. I'm going to do this now because it's such an aberration. It's like too much to bear. Right, let's just try and make this work. Come on. You can do it. Seriously? How could that other one be too steep? And like this one is not having it. Doesn't make any sense. I'm going to have to basically raise the stakes a little bit on this bit right here. I'm going to have to just basically bring it up a bit already, like that, so it already comes up a bit, so that then when it connects more, there we are. So that's a bit smoother, you know. Again, I could probably delete this back a little and just smooth it out a bit more even. There we go. So that is much better now. Just looks better, looks smoother and stuff. Make train rides great again. Yeah, exactly. It would be. This would be a train ride you would take. It's like, you know, if you're taking a train right through a mountain, I think that's one that you would take, you know. I would, anyway. Right, okay, so now we've got this line coming in, and this one's going to be pretty easy. We'll just bring it in, no problem. I always try to keep the lines pretty close to other landmarks. So, and then we get a beautiful bridge coming across here as well. It's a really beautiful bridge. You're gonna love it. It's gonna be amazing. Right, and then we need to find where my connection point is. So it's there. So let's just come around this mountain thingy here, like so. And then I guess we pretty much just come straight across. Da da da, sorted. Right, and that should immediately bring. Oh damn it! Got that little cutting thing going on. Never mind. Okay, cool. So theoretically, a bit of a garbage issue in downtown. I'm actually thinking that we should create. So we do actually have more. We have more garbage services over here. But because there's just such a high population, the demand for garbage collection is extreme. But it's not too many people complaining when you look at it overall. And they are, like, very nearby. It's not that far away. Anyway, so the railway is connected up, so it theoretically should be working now. So all we got to do now is wait for some people to come in. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to save right now, though, because God forbid game crashes. I'm not doing all that again. Right. I really want the... Where's the train? It'll be coming in. Coming in from out here somewhere for sure. It might take some time because it's got to come a little way. There needs to be sort of people actually waiting for it as well, I guess. Right, in the meantime, we've got some other things going on. We've got industry offices, demand, and we've also got the commercial zone. Let's go back to Bodo Peaks. Wow, things are springing up in Bodo Peaks. It's not quite the small mountain town I was anticipating. But I'll tell you what, we'll keep it all low-level residential for the rest because I don't want it to look too sort of big and metropolitan. I want to keep it quite small. So that's what we will do. I think we could definitely do with starting to look at maybe getting a school up here, though, along with other things. Let's get some more commercial in there. Fill that up, get some shops for everybody. Yeah, let's look at education. Let's get a little small school in here. Where's the last zone? Right there. So, oh, bit of a fire in Bodo Peaks. Towering inferno. Yeah, let me just get a small school, like, right there. That's going to make everybody happy. And we can look at some other residential bits and pieces. Right, okay, so that will... Yeah, there's plenty of people coming in here, so that's all good. Oh, we need water supplies. Yes, we do. We do need that. Fantastic. And we can still build down this way as well, don't forget. So I'm actually going to do that. I'm going to fill all this in right here. Got some very interesting mountain dwellings happening. And we can pretty much fill this in with residential, I think, this time. Get a little bit more commercial. This would be like the commercial side here. And get a little commercial over there as well. Cool. So we'll keep an eye on that. Right, yes, garbage collection. I'm not surprised that they're having an issue there, because they have to come quite far to get to it. So what can we do about this? Well, I suppose I could put a small recycling centre somewhere, but they're quite loud. But let's see what we've got on hand. Yeah, this thing. This thing produces a disproportionate level of noise, but maybe the solar... civic amenity site we might get away with somewhere. Maybe I could put it on just the outskirts of town right here. Let's do that. Does that require water? Yeah, it bloody does. Well, do you know what, we're gonna have to build these pipelines out here at some point anyway, so may as well just do it now. It does this thing also produces electricity, but worry about that later. Right, so now that the trucks are en route, they're going to collect that. Now my other concern is snow build-up, but I have to say, I think since I've turned off the weather, the snow build-up doesn't seem to happen. So, yeah. Not sure whether I want to turn the snow back on, actually. Because we're getting some like latency and lag issues a little bit related to that. So late in a place where it snows. You just get out there and wipe it off, it's fine. Plus all the reflections are going to work. Right, now let's see whether we've had any trains come in. It looks like no. But I do see people standing waiting at the station, which implies that there is a train coming. Still no passengers served. I'm going to be hugely disappointed if we don't see a train on the railway line pretty soon. I mean, it's 100% definitely connected. Because we went and checked. So that would be very frustrating. Unless the train was... Oh, oh, oh! Look, look, look. Here we go. There is a train on the line. 19 people out of 240. Well, let's see. Where did it say going to Las Vegas? What? Transporting passengers to Las Vegas. Okay. Alright, let's check it out. Here he goes. He's off into the tunnel. If only we could go to. In he goes. Alright, let's wait for the other side. Oh, there's one going in here, over here. Alright, he'll be coming out anytime soon. Going across the nice little bridge. Plus we've got our amazing road system over here. Here he comes. Going across our nice bridge. Train on train action, yeah. He's taking a nice little passenger route across here. And then straight down into the tunnel again. Down he goes. Man, that looks like a quite steep downhill going in onto this mountain top. And then he's going to come flying out here towards the Great Lakes. He goes very soon. Off and away into the distance. There he goes. Whoa, look at that. Come fly. There's a bit of like whoosh, whoosh, comes catching some air there coming out of the tunnel with the train. That's a train ride that you might want to not take. It doesn't look that steep coming out. Oh, actually, maybe it does. Ah, it's fine. Just like come out and he's like 200 people dead. Right, let's see whether they're over here at the station or whether they're not there yet. I want to see like a train coming in. Yeah, it was catching some big air there coming out of the tunnel. Yeah, it's not a train. Oh, here we go. Here's one coming in. Look, I think we can actually we can travel with them, I think. Yeah, here we go. Oh, look, it's an Amtrak. It's the Amtrak Intercity Phase 3. And it's transporting 86 passengers in. And it's got this classic look, beautiful look to it. So we're riding on the rails coming into town. People who have huge train sets in their basement are usually child predators or serial killers. That's like a harsh generalization. Watch it, he's going to go straight on in. Ooh. Oh my god. We're still travelling with the train. I haven't let go. So it's just taking us on a wild ride. Woohoo! Here we go. I'm not touching anything because I'm just going to let the train thing take us on its own ride. Here we go. Ah, and that was some crazy fun right there. Came out of the tunnel. We're heading on around. Going to go into the next one. These bridges are nice. I like them. Man, he's put his foot down. Look at this, we're getting faster and faster. Here we go into the tunnel. Woo! Actually a little bit of crazy speed here, clipping over the mountaintop. So we're taking... Whoa! We're going right over the top here. Right over the top. There's our city down below. Looking pretty epic. Whoa! We're flying across here. And out we come, straight out of the tunnel. And look at this, look at the beautiful view here coming in the morning. Look at this. Beautiful. Coming across our gigantic bridge now, past the power section, looking awesome. Straight across the houses, wake up because they got a train coming past them. And there we go, flying into the station. Fantastic. Oh, what a ride. So good. Absolutely awesome. Loving it. Choo-choo, indeed. This is one thing that bugs me a little bit with the modded versions of things. They don't turn around. Right, they don't turn around. So now this guy is just like reverse pushing that train, which is, I'm pretty sure is not safe to do. But like you can do it, but I think it's better to pull from the front or something. I think, I don't know. Anyway, well that's good. Anyway, so our rail system is working now, so that's fantastic. Let me just see. I'm trying to work out whether they're. Want to get another path or something going down there, because we've got one here. I'm wondering if I can't path over here a little bit. Let's try and get that. Let's try and get another path going on. Yeah, LT trains run on time, not like Southern Rail, which is the train company I use every day. Bloody nightmare they are. Absolutely useless. Oh dear. Right, okay. Let's have a look. So we're going to get a little path coming down here. Oh, no, wait, the reason why we didn't do that is because there was no way to actually connect it to sort of the paths on the road, right? Yeah, that was the thing. Man, look how many people are using the passageway that I built here, though. Look, look at this. So many people taking the walkway. And look at the people coming out of the subway as well. So many. It's busy times over here. It's busy times in Azidi Ridge. And we built like a whole pathway, you see, that comes across here, like this. And then that takes them to the high school here. And also there's another path which also comes down this way. And that connects to this residence. Because otherwise they'd have to walk like all the way around and it'd be like, take way too long. So don't want to have to be doing that. But yeah, let's just see if there's a way that we can get a pedestrian path to sort of connect from this area down to the other areas. The trouble is, it's a very steep cliff, but I think in theory it can happen. There's a bit of a space here that we could connect to, and I think I could also, we could connect onto the end of this roadway here. It's just going to be quite steep path, you know, so I'm going to try and use my best building skills. What the hell? Didn't mean to do that. Use my best building skills to get this going on. See what happens. It's all going to be fine. Don't worry. First bit of a path there. Can't help but feel it would have been good to do that from the beginning. Hey, do you know what? Even better. Let's just do it like this. Even better than that. Right, then I'm going to step it down a little bit. Just too much. Oh, come on, seriously? There we go. There we go. Right, so a little bit of a step down. This is going to be quite tricky, though. It's quite extreme. We can make this work. It'll be fine. There have to be like kind of gradation. Here we are, this is what we need. Beautiful. We're heading in the right direction. Just keep on bringing it down. This is going to happen. This is fine. No problem there. It's going to be quite a trek to get up here. And now we're down to the easy part. Look, easy now. No problem with this. There you go. There you go. Sorted. Easy pathway up there now. No problem at all. Beautiful. That is quite right. Somebody's going to have to, yeah. It is a lawsuit waiting to happen. Somebody's going to have to get some serious path salting happening on that, let me tell you. Otherwise, there's going to be some really severe ice problems. I can imagine some kids who are like making videos for YouTube are going to get like some kind of tray and sit on it to go down here, especially when it's been a bit icy in the morning. Maybe we'll see. Anyway, there we go. Oh, I'll tell you what, the reason nobody's going to use that path though is because we didn't finish connecting it up. And this is a bit of a theme today, the path that Lutin forgot to connect. We could even connect it up to the other path. That would be even more insane, wouldn't it? Fucking hell, should we go completely crazy? Let's do that and go totally insane. Let's do that. And then we could even build another bit that comes off here that goes round. Then path mad. Look, look, we'll do this. We'll make it happen. Oh my god. There's too much pathing. Oh my god. So much path. So much path. Lady, you just made a black ski scope, not a scope. Black ski scope, not a walkway. Well, I'll tell you who's enjoying it. Mr. Max Adams of worker at Woody's Wood. He's enjoying my paths very much indeed. As is Thomas Roberts, who works at Best of the Best Shops. That's quite a confident name to name your business, isn't it? You're like, yeah, I'm opening a shop. It's called the Best of the Best Shops. The drop-off was probably the safest part of that walkway. Yeah, it's true. Anyway, at least people can easily get down to where they need to go to now. It's quite a trek as well. Like, if you were if you were at the bottom of this path and you saw you had to walk up there, don't know about you guys, but I'd be like, really? Like, fucking... Probably be get my phone and be like, Uber, just I'll meet you at the top. Want to expand my party town? We do actually have a commercial surplus, so yeah, we can look at doing that. Anyway, the city is looking more complex all the time. We're getting some more bridges going on here, so it's all good. Yeah, let's expand Ramos's party town. It's looking good. Look, lots of business coming in here. It's all very well. See a little TNT van there. Right, so let's push this a little bit. We'll just fill in some more. Get that happening. And while we're at it, we could also fill in the sort of hotel district. Some of that happening a bit more. People loving the hotels. Always demand for that. But we've got some more residential demand, so that's an opportunity for us to expand Bodo Peaks a little bit. And we've got some nice houses coming in on these little peaks here. This man right here, the Empire Residence, I think you'll agree, they've got one mother of a view. That's a view you would pay for. Look, their house may be small, but my god, their view makes up for it. Although not quite as good a view as the people living here in the what? The Empire Residence. There's two people called Empire Residence? Well, regardless, maybe they're family, you know, all living in the same area. But I mean, yeah, check that view out. That is a major view going on right there. View of the dam, airport, all of the stuff going down here. So, brilliant, brilliant. Right, okay, so let's expand this a little bit more, residential. We're over 71,000 citizens so far, so that's all looking really good. And still a bit of commercial demand, so we'll get maybe some shops in here, look. Just do that. Brilliant, get that in the mix. More houses in here. Right, let's check out Niltopia. We haven't added anything in here for a little while. Although everything is kind of self-sustaining and doing very well. The city, I think you'll agree, is looking excellent. With its ice rink, its cross-country ski park, it's got a bloody got an opera house. It's got a very big cemetery. It's got a curling park. Not to mention its shopping district here with its big supermarkets and budget technical software or hardware market. It's even got a bloody zoo. So Niltopia is looking pretty hot right here. Bit of a traffic queue getting into town, but we've had that already. It's probably rush hour, right? It's kind of like 8 p.m. but still. I wonder if we could solve that problem by making yeah, do you know what? We can solve this problem, I think, by making this a one-way road. So I'm going to make this a one-way road. I think I'm going to sneeze, which would be bad for the stream. Don't sneeze. Okay, it's fine. Right, we're going to make this a one-way road. That should solve all of our problems. He says, probably, maybe not. Right, so let's see. Yes. So we're going to do that. And then, theoretically, the traffic is going to have to go basically down here and across this section instead. And hopefully they will prioritise sort of going into town this way. We'll just see what happens. However, I remember we made some lane changes on this junction, which means I'm probably going to have to... Oh, actually, they're still working. Oh, that's fine then. Okay, that's fine. Good. Don't have to make those changes. Right, there we go. All of that traffic's going to turn around now. This is, look, rush hour anarchy. I suppose the only issue here maybe is priority with some of the traffic kind of crossing over one another like this. Look. But it's moving pretty smooth. I tell you what might help solve this problem as well is if we make that a no left turn. Make that only a right turn there. I expect the reason is a lot of that traffic, see, yeah, it's feeding this roundabout. But then you see it's going to feed that roundabout, they're going to go in on that junction. So hopefully by making it right turn only, that's what's going to happen, they're going to head on down this way. And that's going to solve a couple of problems on that junction right there. Damn it, they're still turning left. A lot of the traffic which is still turning left on that road is because of the fact that those cars and so on would have had like a preset destination. Right, well, let's see. I think a lot of that traffic, the thing is, they will either turn down onto this road, which is fine because we'll have the setup for that, or they'll just go straight on into town. But either way, I think that will alleviate some of that pressure off of there. Anyway, let's check out what's happening down here in Hobbs Canyon, because we haven't back now. I'll tell you what as well, Hobbs, he's actually not on the live stream this evening. He's going to be disappointed. He's going to be missing out. But anyway, Hobbs Canyon is looking very nicely put together still. We haven't expanded Wraith Hills for a little while, so I'm going to add just a little bit of extra build onto Wraith Hills. Just keep everywhere growing a little bit at a time. So we get those in the mix. All good. Well, the preset destination, I mean, it's, you know, it's just the way it is. It's not a big problem, it's just how it works. Hello, Party Town in Raymas is needing some water, some critical water services. So we just expanded out across the whole thing there. Now, heating, we're doing very well on heating. Let's just check on our services. Electricity, we're good. Water, sewage treatment is not critical, but need to remember to keep an eye on that. Landfill usage is 62%, so that's quite high. I expect it's because a lot of these places are emptying out or so on. I don't know, 0% full, 52, 35. They don't seem too bad. 61, 60, 82. I think we're doing just fine with our garbage collection. I think there's no big problems there. Let's look at healthcare. And generally with health code in, pretty fine. I think we could probably get another little medical place in on this one, though, just to improve things. Maybe we can just get a pharmacy, actually. Just get a pharmacy down here on the end or something. Actually, they're going to need it down here as well. I'm going to put a pharmacy here on the corner, and then we'll get like another small medical center down here. Find a place to put it. Just bang it in the middle there. Sorted. Right. Very important to make sure you have enough medical care for everyone to keep them happy. I tell you what we don't have. We don't have any police up here. We don't have any police either down at Green's Guilty Pleasures either. So I'm going to get a police department in on this. Make sure they're managing the services down here. And we'll get a small local police department for this area here. Or will we? Yes, we'll put one there, and we'll put another one down here. There we go. Making sure the Bodo Peaks stays above the law. Green says no police are needed here. Yeah, they are. They're keeping an eye. We actually already had a police station down there, but now we've got two, so we can really keep an eye on things. Now, one thing we don't have is a city prison, and I think that's one thing that we can start to bring in here. And this is actually like a good location, is we can build it out of town here. So we're going to build the prison out of town here. I'm going to have to connect up this road, finally. So let's get this. We haven't had a reason to really build over here, you see. That's why we kind of left some of these road junctions up. But we can put this prison out here. Need to get some water out here apparently as well. Ah, apparently we do have water. We're not going to give them heating because they're only prisoners, so just use our standard water pipeline. There we go. So now we've got a prison out the way here, and this will be a great place to transport those problem criminals to. It's far enough away from any residential places, people won't complain about it, so that's good. It's way out of the way. That's all very good. Ah, my exhaustion for the last few days is catching up on me. I'm going to get some more water as well. Let's see if there's any interesting buildings we could throw down. New services. I want to get the sea and skyscraper, but we have to construct a harbour for that. There is the transport tower, which is the classic sort of workplace. We've got the mall, we've got the Santander Tower, which I think is already in place. Yeah, we've got that one down. What else have we got here? We've got the big mall, the Grand Mall. Didn't we build that already? Oh, it's got built up here, no? Ah, okay. Well, actually, I tell you what, we were saying before about, like, what else could we add to Newltopia. I think getting the Grand Mall in here is actually going to be a good thing to do, if we have the capacity for it. I tell you what, I'm going to remove this little road here. It really serves no true purpose. And if it means that we can get in a big facility like the Grand Mall, I think it's going to be more than worth it. And even better, the actual audio, you know, the actual sound produced by this thing doesn't actually interfere with anything else, so that looks really good to me. So I'm going to put it smack bang here. There we go. Oh, they love it. Oh, look at that. So much leisure. Everyone is just leisured out. That is going to be a beautiful addition to Newltopia. Fantastic. Jesus, man, that is some thick snow right there in those gardens. It's like about 20 feet deep. Brilliant. Okay, and already people are starting to park up, getting ready here to have a great day out of the mall shops. So that's good. We can get some smaller business in there as well as we go along. And we do have the Brown Rock building, which is a great kind of tourist attraction place. And it feels like it's going to be right at home down here in the business sort of office district. But it's a question of, there we go, getting it in. There we go, nice. It actually has like a little kind of road junction built into it, which is pretty weird actually, but I don't know whether that's because they're wanting it to sort of be true to life or something, I don't know. But we can oblige. There we go. It's good actually because I kind of like having my weird road systems and so on, so this actually works really good. Okay, we've got some more residential and commercial demand. Yeah, brilliant. Brilliant we've got those train systems in there. It's looking really nice. Let's see how many passengers it's served so far. Passengers served last week, 118. Okay, well that's not too bad, I suppose. If they're just going out of town as well. Although I tell you what we could do. Because the rail service comes through here, what we can do, you see, is we can actually bring in other stations. So I can bring in a rural station, look, and put it right here. So we get a rural train station, although it doesn't look like it's going to sit there very well, actually. Because it's not super flat land. It would almost be better to make it, like, along here somewhere. Let's do that. Let's get a road down here that just kind of goes through the valley, because we were going to do this anyway, you know. Let's just bring a road. Let's just get a straight road for starters, right? Just get it like that, and then just connect it up. Because we were pretty much going to build this way anyway. Yeah, see, we're just, there we go, because we're going to bring that road around there anyway, right? And then we can let's bring off a separate bit for the station specifically. That's not what I wanted to happen. I'll have to approach that slightly differently then. So I'm going to try and build it like this. Yeah, that might work. Right, let's get this in. What's this as well? Train line. Draw a train line by clicking the train stations. Oh yeah, so you can make like a line in part. Yeah, so this will work. There we go. And then we can just connect straight through. I always like to do like a... like that. I always like to do like a little tri-junction so they can kind of move properly and so on. Yes. Shigami says, I'm still waiting for his better rambling to subscribe to. It's fine, man. Enough to. Right, okay, let's get some heating and water going on down to this place. There we go. So again, we can get, basically, if I click... Oh, it needs power, really? Okay. We'll use a relay. If I can find a bit to connect it to. There we go. Yeah, so basically we can do create a new line, and then we can go across, and we can go straight to the other station here, add stop. And I don't know whether we have to do a circuit, or whether we can just come back. And do, yeah, just do complete line, like, there we go. So now, we have a local rail service which is going to go from there to there above ground. So that's really good. So that connects those things up. And then we can look at connecting other areas as well. Here we go, look, in fact, look, off he goes. So there goes our train. And look how many trains are coming out from here. There's the backwards Amtrak. How many passengers have you got? Zero passengers. They must be going to collect passengers from over here. The only thing is we already have some, obviously, trains travelling in and out from the main city, so it's going to get quite congested and busy right there. Didn't know Luton had a second channel. A lot of people don't know that. Yet I don't like to make videos about it too much because people think, you know, you're just kind of spamming them then. So I mention it from time to time, but I like to hope that people would just find things themselves, you know. Anyway, let's right. I think we could also do with a little rural train station down here as well. Because if we're going to have train lines, let's just do it all the way. But maybe what we can do is actually try and connect it to this Brown Rock place as well. Look. So you can put another rural station in here, look, and we'll just put it like this. So it's kind of, so it's sort of near to the town, but it's out the way enough that it's not creating lots of noise problems. And then we'll have to build a little line out over here. There we go. And we'll just raise it up slightly. Okay, there we go. So that's another rail line in the mix. Just get some water services out to it. And we can build a path to it as well. So that people can walk. I mean, they can walk there anyway, of course, but... I like building paths to things like the stations and stuff. It just looks cool. Seems the right thing to do. Right, okay, there we go. So now we'll just make another train line here. So I'm going to make a line which goes from there to there and then to here and then back to this one and then back to the start. So again, there we go. So now we've got a lot of transport stuff going on. We've got the underground network, we've got the overground network, we've got the What have we got? We've got the airport. We've got the airport. Did we put taxis down by the airport, though? That's a question. Thinking we didn't. We really should get taxi services going on here. Taxi depot. Oh, actually, there seems to be... oh, wait, no. Maybe I'm wrong. But yeah, we should definitely have a taxi depot down at the airport. It's kind of mandatory, isn't it, really? There we go. Get that in the mix. But then we're going to have to create actually sort of these collection points, which is another part of it. There we go. So we'll put one there. And then I think a lot of people are going to want to grab a taxi from the airport up to some of the leisure districts, right? So we can put some taxi stuff in here. We can get one right here, look. There we go. Put taxi rank in. And then similarly... Why are we above... Why are we below ground all the time? And then we can get another one in here or something. I don't know why I'm below ground with my taxi stuff. We can expand that as we go along. Oh damn, losing a lot of money because we've gone to that nighttime phase. Some of these people are complaining about, what, heating or something? Yeah, look at this. Not enough heat. Maybe we have we've been building, yeah, look, we've been going just below our capacity. So we're going to have to add on to our giant heat complex. There we go. Right, that's going to provide us a bit more heat, but we're going to need quite considerably more, so we're going to have to keep expanding our heat farm. So this huge area is basically just our heat processing facility. And as you can see, it's quite industrial right now. All of these places are basically providing geothermal heat for the city, so it's been quite awesome. Right, here we go. Still need a little bit more residential, so we'll look up at Bodo Peaks, see if we can get a bit more down on this, which I'm absolutely sure we will. We can probably fill in this whole area. Just get all that in the mix, and that. Good times, and then at the other end of town here as well, similarly, we can fill all this in. That'd be good. More than enough, we've got 12 people coming in. Now, there's a lot of people... weekly change leaving now, which probably means that we are missing services in some places, whether it's fire or education or police or water or any of those sort of things. But we can look at that again. Ugh. Aircraft layer. We've got so many aircraft coming in, I think it will be worth our while building the international airport at some point. But the city is looking really amazing right now. Absolutely loving it. Here we are. Let's have a little cinematic. It does look awesome.